Hello guys, welcome back to another episode of The Living World, Season 3 of Guild Wars 2. We're continuing our story and playthrough, and we are going now to be doing the mission called Frozen Out, and we are going also to return to the Sanctuary of the Coden called Sorrow's Eclipse. I didn't notice this before, that this was the name. Maybe it was only mentioned now, or I was not paying attention. And we are going to talk with Deepwater. I always love the Coden names.
Dragon Slayer, I am delighted to see that you have survived your foray into our beautiful countryside. I took down some ice brood. I'm afraid I come bearing bad news, though.
Oh, fool. Gorgon knew it. You found the missing herdmates, didn't you? Oh, boo.
Oh my god.
Unfortunately, yes. There were no survivors. That is quite distressing. Thank you for returning to let us know. We have news on your lost friend as well.
It's bad news, too.
The Svanir are looking for him. They tortured this farmer to find out where he went. The Svanir who hurt you, what did they say?
Oh, the sorcerer was mean. He wanted to know if Quaggan had seen a tall Norn, bald like Quaggan. He made Quaggan tell him where the Norn went. Quaggan didn't want to, but even more, Quaggan didn't want to die.
It's okay. Did he say why he was looking for Braham?
Yes, many times. He was angry because he thinks the Norn wore a disguise and tricked the Svanir out of an elixir recipe.
A disguise? And trick them? Oh no. I'll have to send Timey's sample by courier. I need to find Braham.
He was headed to a cave in the southwest. You might be able to follow the Svanir tracks.
Okay, interesting. As I was saying right in the last episode, in the end, that I wanted to know what is happening to the Rox and Braham, and I guess they're going to do that just now. So I guess they found out about our... so it's over here. I guess they found out about our disguise and we tricked them. Hopefully we didn't get Braham in trouble. Alright, Frozen Out, let's go in. Ah, that's Rox and Garm over there. Okay.
Footprints.
Where?
The Sons of Svanir must not be interested in covering their
There's
tracks.
No footprints, man.
Get off of me.
Kill them all!
That's Rox
that's
over
them.
There.
Commander, take your pick, there's plenty to go around.
Regression. Kill shot.
Damn it. Okay, so we look at... I was so focused on trying not to die that I wasn't even talking, but look at Braham and Rox. They have new armor. Damn it. It's gonna come in the gem store for sure. And I so wanted to... Oh, what the hell? I'm always dying. Stop attacking me. Jesus. They, look at this. Stop. Ah, damn it, they are trying to make me pay, and I want to talk and kill them at the same time, and also show the new armors.
Of this world of reading.
Okay, kill this, damn it. Jackasses. There's a ton of hunters, that's why annoying, because they are shooting each one of them afar and I can't ignore them. Look at that, Braham. Even Frostbite is being more useful than you, that's just standing there, doing nothing. Same old Braham, I missed you. Okay, I just need to kill two more. And we're gonna do it in this one. And this one, it's the last one. It was an elite, actually, the other one.
Are you two okay?
It's fine. Wonder what that was all about.
Did you steal something?
His voice looks different.
They kept calling you a thief.
I'm afraid this is my fault. I had to pose as a Svanir to get their thaw elixir recipe. They must have thought it was you for some reason.
You had to what? Well, it's over now. Rox and I need to keep moving.
Okay, let's go.
Sure. Yeah, sure.
It's good to see you. How's the hunt for the scroll going?
Almost at its end. Or maybe a frustrating beginning. If it's not in this cave system, all my info was wrong and I'm back at square one. Did Taimi get my letter? I assume that's why you're here.
She did. It was quite a surprise after she learned that. How much do you know about what's happening?
With Jormag? Plenty.
No, that's not the... Primordis is active too.
I heard. These dragons won't rest until we're dust.
Well, Taimi has a plan.
I do too. I find a way to kill all the dragons or die trying.
That's a little extreme.
Talk to me after they've taken your mother.
Something up ahead, boy?
Sounds like other wolves!
Oh man, Braham, it looked really, really different. His personality looked a lot more dark. I like that. If that's an imp. The way Braham is gonna go in the future, I think it's gonna be really good. Don't make him, though, even though it gets dark and maybe a little extreme in his actions and starts to ignore more a bit of judgment and stuff like that, still don't make him look stupid. Actually, he should have become a little bit more cautious and not just brunt and like a dumbass. That he was in the past, just going, yeah, let's kill it, and then do nothing or die trying and stuff like that. But it should have that type of... I think you should think like that still, but ugh, come on, I'm gonna die. What I'm trying to say is that you should keep thinking like that, but in a more mature way, if that's the way I can put things. Like, he should be more prepared to be thinking like that. In the past it was more like a teenager going, yeah, let's kill it, and then it would get face rolled in the end. But now he's not so much like that, it seems. At least I didn't get that type of image from him just now. I really, really enjoyed the Braham that he may have become. We'll see in the future episode if this is the... the way his personality is going to develop. Kill that one. Damn it, I'm gonna die. Unless my friends over here help me.
Glad you could help.
Why are they attacking me and only me? Fuck's sake, really? Every single one of them. Got three on top of me, fuck's sake. And another one. Come on.
You can't keep a good chart down.
I don't have the shield, so I'm a lot more squishy.
That was a pretty unfriendly welcome for a fellow wolf, Hogarm.
Yeah, that's true. Woof woof. Okay, maybe we can have a little bit more of talking here.
The dragons aren't the only threats. A Mersat, Lazarus.
We are catching up. Cool. This is nice. Is he gonna say anything?
And the human minister, Cauticus, escaped custody and came out as the leader of the White Mantle. He's currently MIA.
Canox says it looks like he's making his way up to the Isles of Janthir.
Oh man, oh please tell me.
Dark.
Tell
Time
me yes.
And away out
I can't
cavern.
Contain. Oh man, Isles of Janthir, please. Make it happen, Inet. Just give it to us. I need it so bad.
Why is the ground sticky?
The air is so still.
Spiders
here.
Incoming.
Must be the first people to pass through in a generation.
His mask, it's like a predator mask and stuff. It actually looks really nice. Speak to Rox.
You'll have to forgive him, Commander. We've had a pretty tough... Hold up. These eggs. Everywhere. Nobody touch... Never mind. Frostbite is already covered in spider webs. We tripped their alarm.
Okay, so there's a bunch of spiders. Expected. Man, I wish they have to do something about this glint. Activation scream, it's so freaking loud. It's unbelievable. Please, really, Annette, reduce that, because that kills me. I can't have the rest of the game a little bit louder to hear the NPCs talking and hear the effects and the music and stuff, and suddenly there's Glint screaming on my ears. So please fix that someday. I don't know. Okay, last one now. Guess not. Okay, at least these ones are not attacking me directly, so I already thank them for that. And more. They are getting bigger, I guess. There's one over there doing nothing, just chilling. Okay, we are not being efficient over here. One frostbite is slacking over there. Rox is attacking a different one. Braham is attacking. Okay, they suddenly decided to attack. Rest me. Okay, good job, Ram. Okay, last one. Dodge. And it's gonna die any second.
That's the last of them. Looks like we might be able to get through there if we can clear that web.
Use your torch, Rox.
That did it. Let's pick up the pace before more spiders show up.
Braham, the reason I found you, I don't know if you heard, but we started a new guild.
Haha.
It'd be great to have you.
It didn't feel like joining Destiny's Edge and continuing their legacy, huh?
Ritlock said, I felt like that might be... might come across as disrespectful.
Disrespectful? To keep the memory of my mother and Snaf going? You and I must have different notions of respect.
Braham, I'm sorry. This isn't the reaction I expected.
It's okay, Commander. Maybe it's for me to keep alive. Another thing thrown on my pile of obligations now that I'm back home.
Braham?
This scroll isn't going to find itself. Let's go.
This is awesome.
Watch it.
Ah, come on, I love this. I don't know, maybe it's my appetite for destruction, but I love the fact that not everyone is just loving me as being the commander and doing everything I say. We had the Marjorie in the last episode, putting up to herself. Now we have Braham with his new ideas, and I mean new ideas because he was a doofus. He would just do everything, and he was like a yes boy, doing everything we told him. Oh man. And now I really start to enjoy the characters a lot more. Casimir has been a little bit, not a little bit, she's been missing in action like for a lot of time. I don't know when they are going to develop her story a little bit more. We'll see what plans they have for that, maybe something related with Kodakus. We will see, but there was a time that I regret. Okay, shut up, let's listen.
Might be in the next chamber then. If we could get through the ice wall, maybe Frostbite can fit through the crevice. Where there's the Braham way.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Again, starting to cheer for Braham. Oh man. Okay, so as I was saying previously, I had to shut up to listen to the characters. There was a point that I really regretted that we had so many characters being part of the gang, because I started to believe that they were not being able to develop their characters as they should have, because there was so many characters with us that we had to give playtime and show them to. And now I don't know what they did, but they started to develop the personality of each character a lot more. They are not even a slightly bit similar to what they were in the past. They look a lot more mature, and I really, in the past it looked like a gang of teenagers trying to fight prevent the end of the world by the Elder Dragons, and now it's getting a lot better, so... Really, really, keep up the good job, my net.
It's here!
It's here, what's there? It's like a Minotaur, Abomination, sort of ice bread.
I'll take that, thanks!
Yeah, I guess so.
Move. Rocks!
Damn it, Braham.
She's frozen solid. Stay out of that thing's way.
Okay. We have to slay the ice bit to find the frozen scroll. Okay, it's focusing me somehow. Okay, we can't kill this stuff like this. It's gonna be a mess. Normal means of clearing the ice piece. Define spiral will be ineffective. So what are we supposed to do to damage it? This creature is generating dense gold directed at the nearby block of ice.
Faster.
Okay, so I guess we have to find out what to do. Okay, so we are in trouble. And we have no idea what to do. We are gonna die for sure. Okay, so let's think this through. What are we so... Oh, come on, even here. You don't give me a break, do you? Maybe if you stun them all... I don't know, it didn't work. They don't take damage at all either.
Nice and weak.
Ugh, I really don't get it. What are we supposed to do? Okay guys, we're back again. Hopefully the game won't screw us over again and bug. So let's do this nice and clean now. Position myself between the boss and these guys so that the boss kills them himself. That's the tactic. Which I had to Google it sadly to find out, otherwise it's either luck or you have to know it. I don't see any way, at least I didn't see any hints to solve this at all. Kill these ones. Good. Okay, kill these two.
Endurance drained.
Just, oh my god. Why is he? Oh, fuck's sake. Okay, he didn't hit a single one, but I was badly positioned. Damn it. Okay, kill that one. Okay. Good. I really want these ones to die. Please focus me. What the heck? He dodged it. What was that? What the hell was that? No, I didn't do it. Oh, fuck me, I'm an idiot. I can't believe it. Fuck's sake. Can't believe I did that. Come on, charges, we are here. Stop what the hell you're doing. Okay, good. Really, kill this one. It's getting really annoying. The fact that this one is not dead yet. Okay, I guess he's gonna... Oh, fuck me. Really?
I have returned.
Okay, I'm here. Come here.
I don't
what the hell is he doing? Oh my god. Jesus. Okay, kill the... Oh my god, this one is here. Okay, at least that one is gonna die. The other one is coming our way. Okay, good. Shit, I'm dead again. Ugh, I wasn't paying attention to my health bar at all. I can't, if there's achievements with this boss, which probably there is for sure, it's gonna be a mess. I can already foresee it. No, don't you dare come up here, not end bug again. This guy's still alive, oh come on. But you're gonna die now. Fuck's sake, why are you going over there? Stop going to that location. Annoying little shit. Okay, come to this one.
It was a fake.
Okay, this is the last one. Use your charge. Good, it's gonna die, finally. Can we now hit him? The scroll is here, okay good. I don't know what scroll is this, seriously, I hope this is some scroll. Good lore coming up.
It was true.
Thank the wolf.
Wolf, it was true. For the might of the fire lives in my heart and in this bow. No chill will extinguish its light. Was that it? Did it work? Only
one way to find out.
Even now, man, no pants. Seriously, my hips are broken. Case he went ablaze. And now we can damage him. There's no protection anymore. Avoid it now. I don't know, is it supposed to hit rocks to get her out of her prison? Maybe they're gonna stay here in case it does something, but I guess not. He's gonna die. Beast slain quick. I did an achievement, I guess.
What happened?
You were frozen.
I was frozen? So weird. It was like a dream and I was on a beach. You think it'd be the opposite.
What the hell?
Well, we're glad you're back.
Did we get the scroll?
Sure did, Rox. Thanks.
And now?
This is similar to the scroll Aesgeir used in his great victory. So now I test the bow on the tooth in the Great Hall. If I damage it, it's time to rally the Norn and lay Chorn back to rest.
Oh my god, it's really gonna happen in the next episode, probably.
Let's hold up a second here. A direct assault on Jormag puts a lot of lives on the line. I think the Pact can tell you that may not be the best idea.
The Pact you commanded? Look, Jormag is my problem, and I'll deal with it my way. With or without you.
Jormag isn't just your... Look what happened to Rox when you rushed in and bashed something.
Oh, I forgot. Your calculated plans always work out perfectly. Like when you posed as a Spawnier to get some potion.
Okay. Can we back up? Timey thinks there may be a way to pit Primordis and Jormag against each other without raising a single sword.
Timey thinks, huh? If the tooth chips, we have hard proof.
Hard proof of what? That you can battle a tooth?
So only you get to decide when we take down a dragon? Only you are allowed man. To kill them?
That's not what I'm saying.
Well, figure out what you're saying, because that's what it sounds like.
I'm only asking you to wait. Maybe just a few days. See if Timey can do this. There could be no need to put lives at risk.
With every moment we wait, someone else's mother dies. I won't give Jormag a few days. I won't give Jormag a few minutes.
The Norn elders told me the legend of the tooth. But I've also been out in the world and faced two of these things. One with you. They're not to be taken lightly.
You think I take it? You know what, Commander? I'm glad you didn't join Destiny's Edge. My mother wouldn't want you in there. I'm headed back to Holbrook. Garm, to me.
So
yeah.
Go ahead. He certainly doesn't want to be around me right now.
Do you think he'll do it?
I hope cooler heads prevail. He has to see this isn't the way to go.
Oh man. The tooth chipped, I guess. This is the last episode, right?
Finished with that.
Yeah. Damn it. I wanted more. Okay, got this. And a mastery point. So, did you see that? Like, Braham was all over us. He really has, like, some nasty feelings toward us for some reason. I think not. He's still for sure reeling the loss of his mother, but his negativity is not being directed towards Rox, maybe because he sees Rox in a different way, and he's now like, making us the reason that his mother died, because we were the one that orchestrated the plan or was like coordinating the attacks against Mordremoth, and his mother was taken in that attack with a pact in which we were the commander. So even though Traherne was there and he was the general, the marshal actually, we were also a part that directed the operations in the pact. So I guess his feelings are coming now toward us, and this is I know it can sound silly because Braham is still maybe look like he's acting childish, but these reasons now are different. He's not just being like stupid and dumb for no reason, any sort of reason that could be like expectable. Now he's being blunt, and but because of his emotions are holding his judgment, and that's a different level of maturity, even though it's really hard to maybe understand the complexity of the character it's getting now. And I really do enjoy the fact that Annette went this way, and even though Braham keeps being the same as before, is the way he's portraying that, it's not the same reasons as before. So the fact that his mother died is the main reason for his bluntiness now, instead of his just being stupid. And even though he keeps making some mistakes, like now he went to fight the beast and he put Rox at danger. So yeah, I really enjoy that. But then again, this comes with the same principle that from the last episode. Even Marjorie was not taking our orders for just because we were commanding her. This is a different thing that is happening now, since we are not even the pact commander anymore. Our influence on the other characters is diminishing, and I really think that is a good thing. I think that, as I said before, we are a part of the puzzle. The player character shouldn't be the main hero. The heroes should be the characters around them, because they are the ones that compose the world of Tyrion, not the character itself. Otherwise, when you go to the wikis, you don't feel the mysticism of seeing, oh look, this character, he looks so powerful, like the things we have with Livia and what is happening to her now. If we did the things that Livia did, it wouldn't be, I don't know, it wouldn't be as impactful as it is with the character of the world, so that are part of the world, even though we are on character also, but we can't have a name because we are the characters the players want to do. So I really enjoy the way things are going now. Overall, this episode that released maybe was the, in terms of story progression, it was probably the weakest one, because it didn't go much anywhere. It was the release of the map, because I think they put quite a bit of focus on it. I don't know, is this the biggest map they've released so far? Maybe, not sure. Maybe Ember Bay is still the biggest, or they are close to each other. But yeah, I really think this was a good episode, not as good as the previous ones, because the other ones had quite a lot more impact in the end with the reveals that they have done. We know here that the tooth chip, so I don't know if the Norn are going to battle. That would be epic, and yeah, probably a lot of lives would be lost, but this is how epic shit happens. There's lots of battles and big ones where people die, and especially the Norn have a culture of fighting in battles and dying in great battles, and they don't care as long as they fight a great enemy, which honors their legend that will be told by other Norns. So even though the most logical thing to do is to hear to Tymi, I don't know, maybe Annette can find in telling the story a middle ground, trying to give us like some sort of epic battle. I wouldn't mind even if they can't do it with the actual gameplay, which would be the best. But if they can't do that, even a cutscene would be nice somehow. So yeah, maybe they can find a middle ground between Time is Solution and going into an epic battle against Jormag. We'll see what happens in the end. So yeah guys, thanks very much for watching this whole playthrough. If you stay till the end, again, thanks very much for supporting what I do. I'm trying to improve. I know I do a lot of mistakes and yeah, I'm starting slowly, getting somewhere maybe. So yeah, thanks very much for watching. I'll see you next episode of Living World, which is probably only coming in January because, you know, Winter's Day and Christmas and all that, and then I won't be releasing much like yeah, anything at all until January. So yeah, see you then guys, bye.